Good morning, students. I am Pragati, your psychology teacher, and today I have brought chapter 4 and starting of introduction about the human behavior development. And in this chapter, before moving further, we need to be very clear regarding growth and development. So today class, we are going to understand the two points, what is growth and what is development, the difference between growth and as well as development, because this is the basic thing which we need to understand before understanding the human development. Because most of the time, many of the children get confused in these kind of definition or words. Sometimes we consider growth and development in the same way, because in this there is some increase, but initially there are some changes which should be taken care of and we need to note down as in psychology students. Because in growth, something is related with only physical development, whereas development is related with something which is overall development. For example, it relates with the physical, psychological, biological and other perspectives. So let's start with the growth and development differences. First of all, if we understand in the growth is referred to the increase in size. Increase in size, like it is physical size and physical development. Like you have at a particular age group, your height increase, your overall the time period, your body parts gets differentiated, changes will occur according to the maturity level, and then like hair growth, everything is related with the growth. Okay, where the increase is there in a size and which is related with the physical development. Physical, aapke nails hai, aapke hairs hai, all things that are related with the growth. Okay, so there is a physical development or physical growth is related with the increasing of the size. Now, on the other hand, if we see that the development, it is a progressive, orderly and predictional change in which the pattern has been changing and the development take place in all the perspectives, whether the perspectives are related to your psychological perspective, whether it is related to your biological perspective, social, emotional, cultural, all these are the patterns development which has been taken place during the progressive developmental period. Okay, now if we talk about the growth, the second point which we need to note down is about stop after certain age. If we say that the growth stop after certain age, for example, in girls our height stops after 18 years, and in boys it stops after 20 to 21 year of age, right? In girls it stops in 18 to 19 year. So this is a time period where the complete body development take place, and after that the declines comes. Okay, so we know that the growth, the increasing of the size stops at and after some particular time period, like 19 year, 20 or 21 year. After that the decline start coming in the body. Okay, whereas if we talk about the development part, in this it is a lifelong process. Why? Because here we are getting an increase in the knowledge, and whether it is related with your cognitive development is something in which your reasoning increase, your knowledge related to your language, communication skills, other certain skills, activities increases, and all that is related with your life process. As we grow older, but the development does not stop. So your social circle increase, whether your psychological perspective, your thinking abilities increase, everything, every place you get some or other kind of experiences which is considered under development. Now coming on the third point, includes only gain in quality. Means हमें सिर्फ इसमें जो अगर if we talk about only growth, यहाँ पे qualitative जो gains है वो ही include होते हैं. Only qualitative growth ही हो रही है. Certain period of time तक we can see that only some kind of perspectives are only increasing. Like if we are talking about like we have only physical growth, so we can see that only bodily changes are taking place and the quality of the things have been changing in your body, right? Biological perspective se agar aap dekh sakte ho, genetical perspective se aap dekh sakte ho. So all that are related with only the qualitative part which is for the certain period of time. But if we comes over the developmental period, it include both gains and losses. Everything throughout your lifespans means whether you are gaining something in your life or you're losing some experiences or something in your life, that is also considered in development. Because if we lose something, we also learn some kind of lesson from the particular thing, and that become an experience of life, and that is also a part of development. So whether it is gain or loss, both are the part of development. But here the gain is only considerable, means after 21, after 30s, when the body start declining, that is not considered under growth. But if we consider in the development part, there till the old age this is being considered under the progressive, as we say till the end of our life we learn something, right? So that is considerable in development and differentiate with growth. Now coming on the fourth point, this is less plastic, mostly influenced by the genetical makeup. Okay, I just highlight this word, genetic makeup. Genetic makeup से हम क्या समझते हैं कि your genes have been transferred to you from the forefather, and that genetical change is also considerable. If your parents are of a particular height, your height will also be dependent on their genetical change which dominates in your body. But if it cannot be happened, like if your parents are smaller in size, you will become tall. Okay, so this is the differentiation, means your genetical circumstances are also responsible for the growth purposes. So your forefather relative height, the average height is been considerable. From that some amount of change can be come, but not a large number of difference can be considerable. So less plastic and mostly fluent by the genetical makeup. Now if we talk about development part, in this it is highly plastic, means can be improved. Development can be improved. For example, I told that we have some losses in our life, we get through some losses of life, there we learn a lesson and we improve ourselves, right? For example, taken from your daily life only, you are studying, but due to some reason you won't be able to cope up with your syllabus and you could not get good marks. So that affect your body, about your initials or academic life, or you don't get good average marks, that become a lesson for you, because that loss make a positive motivation for the next time working hard, to work hard for the next time, it help you out. And that is the most important thing which we need to understand, that improvement is required in development. Some kind of improvement definitely comes, whether it is a gain or a loss. Okay, now coming on the fifth point of growth, this is only quantitative. If we talk about about the growth side, it is only quantitative if we compare it to the developmental side, because in developmental it is being influenced by the historical conditions. How? Now the dual growth is as it relate with your genetical makeup. Similarly, in growth, a perspective, there is a life shade of perspective which has been responsible, like milestones. It has been related, like you are having a particular time period and a number of steps which has to be taken place, and at every step you will gain a particular amount of growth. Okay, so this is something which we say that it is only quantitative, not qualitative, or not historical condition. Means social gathering या social environment, culture का हमारी growth पे कोई effect नहीं पड़ता है. Moreover, it affect us by the qualitative or genetical factors. Okay? If we talk about the developmental side, in this we see that it is related with the historical condition. Influence means यहाँ पे आपको social and इकोनॉमिकल जो फैक्टर्स हैं दैट आर वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द डेवलपमेंट. योर कल्चर, योर एनवायरमेंट कंडीशंस, एवरीथिंग टीचेस यू समथिंग अन अनदर, एंड दैट इज रिलेट विद योर डेवलपमेंटल साइकिल. ओके, सो दिस इज समथिंग विच रिलेट विद योर हिस्टोरिकल कंडीशंस. मीन्स आपकी पास्ट एक्सपीरियंसेस के, आपका कल्चर कैसे आपको किन नॉर्म्स और वैल्यूज को हाईलाइट कर रहा है, और आप आगे क्या सीख रहे हो अपने पर्टिकुलर एनवायरनमेंट से, दैट इज रिलेट विद द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ विच इज बीन इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय हिस्टोरिकल कंडीशन. नाउ कमिंग ओवर द सिक्स्थ पॉइंट, दैट इज इंडिविजुअली फॉर्म्स सिमिलर पैटर्न, मींस माइलस्टोन्स एट डिफरेंट प्लेस. नाउ व्हाट डज इट मींस, लाइक I have told you earlier also in the quantitative part that every step takes some kind of value or quantity, but on the other hand we need to see that the individually we need to see the some kind of changes, and these some kind of changes are only due to the steps we have been taking place. For example, an infant, there is some things which need to be noted down, and only that much development will be take place. After that, when the child moves to childhood, there he will learn some kind of steps, then move to the other ladder, that is early adolescence, then the late adolescence. And in everything, as we learn some language, we need to understand about the words, right? First we'll learn ABCD and then make the sentence. Na? Similarly, the in growth, there are some milestones. Means first, the basic initial steps have been taken place during the infancy and childhood, and on that basis, other body development or other developments take place. But whereas in the development, these are both qualitative and quantitative. Means हम quantity के हिसाब से भी बहुत सी चीजें learn करते हैं, और quality के हिसाब से भी हमें क्वालिटेटिव नॉलेज भी मिलती है और क्वांटिटेटिव नॉलेज भी हम गेन कर रहे हैं. यहाँ पे हम एक नंबर ऑफ अमाउंट ऑफ नॉलेज भी हमें मिल रही है, और एक मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ अमाउंट की नॉलेज भी हमें हम गेन कर सकते हैं. इट इज ऑल अपॉन अस दैट हाउ डू वी स्टडी और व्हाट काइंड ऑफ नॉलेज डू वी नीड और वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन. सो वी हैव ऑल द पर्सपेक्टिव, वेदर सोशल, कल्चरल or biological, psychological, any kind of perspective, but we can study all or we can learn each and every perspective of development. Okay, and one more thing, that growth is a part of development, and development is in vast form. Okay, it is a sub part of development. It is, that's why it is differentiated from the development, but it is very compact. But if you talk about development, it is completely a vital range of lifespan which moves all over our life, and some kind of experiences we gain. Okay? So So this is all about the growth and development. Now you just make a chart on basis of this and then note down your notes in that. Thank you and have a nice day.